What's new in PKanalix 2023? This version includes both big and small new features to make your workflow more efficient. One of the major improvements is a data formatting module in the interface to make the input format more flexible. In this module, you can load an input dataset not yet in a standard monolix suite format and adapt its format. For this, you can specify several header lines or exclude lines, merge several observation types into a single column with different options, add censoring information based on BLQ tags, add treatment information from an external file or specifying it manually with a myriad of possibilities such as multiple doses, repeat cycles, amount read from a data column are given manually, infusions, combined therapies, or dose intervals handled as occasions. And finally, add covariate and regressor columns from another file. You can see the formatted dataset in the interface or export it as a new file. Additionally, after accepting your dataset, when defining units for dataset columns, it is now possible to define amount units normalized by weight or area. The units of the NCA parameters will adapt accordingly. Another major improvement is a brand new reporting module to automatically generate reports as Word documents with all your analysis results. With the default option, you can generate in just one click a default report containing different tables and plots, depending on which tasks were run. If a project contains NCA results, the report will contain tables with NCA settings, individual NCA metrics, and summary, and a summary table of metrics, as well as plots generated and customized in the interface. For example, in this project, I have generated plots for observed data with mean curves for different dose groups, covariate viewer, and individual fits colored by dose group. If a project contains CA results, the report will also contain a table with CA settings, individual CA parameters, a summary table, and a cost table, in addition to all the plots available in the interface. To generate the plots in this report, I also took advantage of the new capabilities of PKanalix 2023. In the observed data, I can now overlay statistics for different groups on the same plot thanks to the merge button. And on this same plot, I can now select custom axis limits. For example, here, I set a lower limit of 0.01. Maybe you noticed that in the report, plots are zoomed in compared to how they look in the interface. Font size and margins in plots were automatically increased during the default report generation to make plots ready for publication. To generate a custom report, you need to load a custom report template as a Word document that contains any text you want, as well as descriptions of tables and plots. We call these descriptions placeholders because PKanalix can automatically replace them by the corresponding tables or figures to produce your final report. You can see the placeholder directly in the interface with this button. In the window that opens, you can easily edit the placeholder settings, for example, to increase the size of all elements with the zoom value, and see the result right away with the preview button. Or copy the placeholder to paste it in your report template. Your template can even include customized table styles or several versions of the same plot with different settings. You can notice that tables in the report contain NCA metrics names that are different from the default names in the interface. This is now possible thanks to the new feature that allows changing the names of parameters and how they appear in tables, plots, and reports. A lot of changes have been made to the compartmental analysis module of PKanalix as well. It is now possible to use library models for multiple libraries, or even custom models written using the MLX run syntax. New weighting option 1 across ypred times yobs was added and is set by default. The CA algorithm has been improved to have a better chance of escaping local minima and improving the fit. It is now possible to see the individual cost reported in the individual parameters table, as well as global cost in the brand new cost tab. AIC and BIC estimators are also reported. Additionally, you can diagnose model misspecifications in a more efficient way using the new observations versus predictions plot available after running CA. PKanalix summary tables for both CA and NCA now contain two additional metrics, geometric CV and harmonic mean. Furthermore, the latest version of PKanalix is even more connected than before with other applications of the Monolix suite. In particular, you can now export your PKanalix CA runs to Simulix to simulate new scenarios for the individuals present in the dataset. To summarize, with the addition of data formatting and reporting of the results, as well as more connections between applications to combine analysis as needed, you can perform your entire analysis workflow in the Monolix suite interface. What is your favorite feature? Tell us in the comments. In addition, to give us feedback and help us fine-tune the new features in the next versions, you can now use this form integrated within the interface. Enjoy the new version of PKanalix. To see the new features for all applications in more detail, watch our last webinar to see the Monolix suite in action with a PKPD case study.